By the way, a recent study reported that single women would choose their dog over a man. Well, itaas ang kamay ng mga single dyan. Can we blame them? Married women actually might do the same. Today, 2 in 3 Filipino households, 2 in 3 Filipino households own a pet, and whether furry or feathered, are showered with tender, loving care. The members of this chamber are no exceptions. I myself have several beloved pet dogs and even a tortoise, and who consider as part of our family. And just between us, they are actually sometimes more loving and more behaved than my actual kids. Actually, nakikita nyo, behave nga sila tayo. Daldal lang daldal dito kanina. Habang nagsasalita ako, sila nakaupo lang. Sadly, despite their worth and value to human society and the existence of laws criminalizing cruelty to animals, many of them are still maltreated, neglected, and even tortured. Today, we have here Coffee and Bear Brand. Yung si Coffee may taga dito sa ulo. Si Bear Brand naman, naputulan na ng paa. At meron din dala ang biyaya na naka-wheelchair na aso. They basically spent for that. Thank you, Rina. Mr. President, paano ba nating dapat ratuin ang mga hayop? Livestock, as mentioned, is often been trumpeted as a billion-a-day industry. But the problem with highlighting the bottom line is that it can be a built-in excuse to treat without ethics the animals that are crucial for survival. Occupying the top of the food chain does not give us the license to handle animals with barbarity. Because if such is how we treat them, then we lose our humanity. We abdicate our God-given role as their stewards. Just a few months ago, it was reported that the Philippine Animal Welfare Society, PAWS, is now taking steps in filing a case of animal cruelty against a security guard who was caught on video throwing a puppy from a pedestrian bridge. Hindi lahat ng security guards ganyan. Marami nga sa kanila, bantay nila, kasama nila magbantay ang mga aso. Pero ito, ganun ang nangyari. Animal abuse can be committed not just by extreme violence or torturing for sadistic pleasure, but also through simple neglect and abandonment. One of the issues that has been the cause and effect of neglect is the overpopulation of homeless animals. Mr. President, this situation has led to an urgent problem. Rabies in humans is on the rise. Rabies is endemic or constantly prevalent in the entire archipelago. The Philippines is, in fact, ranked number 6 among countries with the highest rabies incidence in the world. It is timely, then, that March is Rabies Awareness Month, which makes this the best time to shed light on rabies in humans, in animals, and other animal welfare issues. It has long been agreed upon by health workers that in order to eradicate rabies in humans, we must eradicate rabies in animals, keep our neighborhoods stray-free, and implement effective animal control. The question, of course, is whether we have sufficient animal welfare programs in place and whether our communities, especially in rural areas, have adequate access to quality veterinary health care services. Under Republic Act 7160, or the Local Government Code, the delivery of the veterinary services to the communities has been devolved to LGUs. However, the Local Government Code, RA 7160, mandates that only provinces and cities should have their own veterinarian officers. Hence, there's a reported shortage of veterinary personnel in municipalities, and many veterinarians are actually unsung heroes because they have been working tirelessly with inadequate resources. On the national level, the responsibility of ensuring animal welfare falls under the purview of the Bureau of Animal Industry, or BAI, a staff bureau of the Department of Agriculture. However, the effective and proper implementation of animal welfare laws is hindered by the BAI's insufficient budget and lack of permanent personnel. Furthermore, it is without direct control over regional and local veterinary services. Mabuti na lang, Mr. President, may ilang mga animal welfare organizations na handang tumulong at magboluntaryo ng kanilang serbisyo sa iba't ibang munisipyo. Foundations and NGOs such as Biyaya, CARA, POS, AKF, Animal Rescue, Potion Project, and PETA rescue animals suffering from abandonment, abuse, or injury, or neglect. They house them in animal shelters and provide care while waiting for their potential adopters and fur parents. Marami ito volunteers. Hindi nagbibigay ang gobyerno nga ng pera dito eh. Pera nga nila eh. Katulad nung kay Rina Ortiz, kasama rin ang mga iba't ibang mga NGOs. Kay Ms. Kuuning. Biyaya went as far as Pag-asa Island in the West Philippine Sea to provide kapon services to the stray animals there. Meron yata tayong video dyan. Walang bayad po yun, ha? Ang sabi nga ng mga taga-Biyaya, ito.
Maraming salamat po. The dogs of Pag-asa Island in the Kalayaan Group of Islands wish to thank you.
Dala rin sila ng mga pagkain. Mr. President, just watching that, diba? Imagine the effort to go there, and this is done privately. AKF has led a launch campaign against the dog meat trade, while POS has successfully pursued legal action and secured a number of convictions against animal officers. PETA and Potion Project, or People for Ethical Treatment of Animals, helped rescue and care for working horses and other animals that were left behind when Taal volcano erupted.
Kaya kami po nakukonsensya kahit hindi amin, kaso wala kami magawa, inuna namin yung sa amin. Kaso inabot na rin, katulad kanina, hinaharang na uli. Paano pa namin sila matutulungan?
Project sponsored Break for Animals in cooperation with the MMDA to prevent roadkill and injury to all our furry friends who cross the roads. CARA continues to educate and disseminate information concerning animal welfare, animal care, animal control, and other animal-related concerns. On the other hand, corporations like Mars Petcare share their scientific expertise with government agencies to advance pet food standards in the country. Mr. President, isa din yan sa ating itutulak later on, na magkaroon din ng standard kung ano ba talaga yung tamang nutrition para sa mga aso, hindi yung kung saan-saan lang nagbebenta ng pet food na hindi natin alam kung paano ang production at ang source. On the other, however, we cannot rely on individual efforts alone. Rather, a whole of community approach is necessary on the part of us policymakers. Our job is to beef up our laws on animal welfare, which will establish a respectful coexistence with animals by improving their living conditions. In response to this situation, I proposed a law, Senate Bill Number 2458, to be known as the Revised Animal Welfare Act. The original law, Republic Act No. 8485, as amended by RA 10631, is considered a landmark in legislation. The founders of POS led the lobby for its passage. Today, we seek to strengthen this law. Our bill seeks to improve the capacity of the Department of Agriculture in addressing animal welfare issues through a proper bureau which will be given sufficient budget and permanent personnel. This will enable them to be more effective in implementing and enforcing policies. This bill shall firmly establish standards geared towards engendering responsible pet ownership as well as ethical behavior and accountability from all those who have control over or provide care to animals. As such, the bill has more stringent penalties for violations of the Act. Furthermore, the bill creates a Barangay Animal Welfare Task Force, which will enable local officers to address the animal welfare issues with dispatch. Perhaps the DILG might consider this as one of the metrics for awarding the seal of good governance to a municipality. Finally, Mr. President, recognizing that the urgency and enormity of the situation call for all hands on deck, Section 11 of the bill provides that the Secretary of the Department of Agriculture shall deputize animal welfare enforcement officers, all volunteers who have undergone the necessary training. I would like to end the speech with a few heroic tales. There was a dog named Hugo who lived with his human family in Panabo City, Davao. Hugo had successfully defended his family from snakes that morning. Beside him was torn pieces of the Samar cobra, a highly venomous species of spitting cobra. Hugo died defending his home of 7 years. Meanwhile, in Zamboanga, Kabang, a stray puppy, was adopted by Rudy Bungal. One day, Bungal's young daughter and her cousins attempted to cross a busy street. Seeing an oncoming motorcycle, Kabang jumped in front of it, shielding the kids, but suffered extensive injuries on her snout. Kabang's story caught worldwide attention, and this dog was honored for her heroism in a Philippine stamp. Thus, the prospect of life without animals by our side is a sad and lonely one. With that, Mr. President, I would like to end my privileged speech with a call for the immediate passage of the bill. And I'm glad that Senator Cynthia, the head of the Committee on Agriculture, has already met with our advocates. And in fact, she has a farm, and she also has her own pound for stray dogs in Las Piñas. Her son has, I don't know, 20 dogs. I know that she'll be very supportive. I would also like to thank the animal welfare organizations, in particular, Ms. Rina Ortiz of Biaya. She was the first one who actually went to our office, because I've been really seeing it on many social media pages, and I've been already pondering how we can help them, and I'm glad that many organizations had reached out to us. Attorney Heidi Kagiwa of AKF, Ms. Nancy Kuunying of CARA, Ms. Malu Perez of Poshon Project, Ms. Jana Sevilla of PETA, other individual advocates, representatives of the Department of Agriculture and BAI, and our city veterinarians, and Johnny Racoma and company of Mars Pet Care, who have graced our halls today. I would also like to thank, personally, some friends who I know have been caring for the welfare of animals. I have Valerie, Joanna, Malu, Chari, Bettina, and many others, and also, of course, the wife of the Senate President herself, who actually is here, Audrey. Thank you so much for being here today. Also, the sister of our colleague here, Anna, thank you. If I forget to mention, all of you are present here today. I really appreciate you showing support. So to end this, by the way, please allow your pets to enjoy the mini dog park that we have set up there. Pero itong mga kasama nating mga aso, masuswerte ito. Marami sa kanila, meron ng kumupkop at mga nag-aalaga. Yung isa nga, sinasabi na pabayaan daw sa kusina, di ba? Pero marami tayong mga aso din at mga iba't ibang mga hayop na kailangan din ng pagtulong ng ating gobyerno at pagkakalinga. Nung ako'y nag-umpisa dito, Mr. President, sabi ko nga, ang isa sa mga unang bills na tinula ko ay National Lunch Feeding Program para sa mga bata. Ngayon naman, para sa ating mga alaga. Dahil hindi naman po bumoboto yung mga yan, pero sila po ang mga talagang nangangailangan ng boses natin dito sa Senado. So, yun lang po. Maraming salamat. Meron pong isang video para happy naman yung ating last video. Thank you, Mr. President.
Senator Grace po for this very special occasion. I'd like to let the sponsor know, this is probably an historic day for the Senate. This is the first time that I've seen animals inside the Senate. In a session hall. Animals with four legs, ha? Kasi maraming animal na two legs. But it's the first time I've seen animals with four legs in the Senate. So this is a historic day. And I think, Majority Leader and my dear colleagues, we are going to transfer our home to BGC very soon. I think we should make it a pet-friendly building, right? Let's make it a pet-friendly building where we can take our pets. It's a big, you know, for me, when I saw my dog, my blood pressure just went down so low. I was so happy to see my pets here, my two dogs. Aside from my wife. My wife does not give me high blood. She gives me low blood and she makes me relax. I'm her pet, actually, in the home. I'm her pet. Okay, so, Majority Leader.
Thank you. Mr. President, I cannot help but just mention, Mr. President, that a staggering population of stray cats and dogs estimated at 12 million in 2019. It highlights the dire situation that our animal companions face without proper shelter, without proper food and care. So, Mr. President, let me just state into the records of this August chamber na buong-buo po yung suporta natin doon sa Senate Bill number 2458 ng ating kasamahan, Senator Grace po, ang Revised Animal Welfare Act at sa pagtataguyod ng kapakanan ng mga hayop, Mr. President, yung yes. Four-legged po, Mr. President. And Mr. President, we thank again our distinguished colleague, Senator Grace po, for fighting against animal cruelty and advocating for animal welfare. Maraming salamat, Mr. President. Mr. President, I think Senator Risa would also like to make a short manifestation, Mr. President.
Can I add something?
Senator Grace po is also seeking
Senator
the floor.
Grace,
may I move that she be recognized, Mr. President?
Yes, I would also like to thank Senator JB for bringing his very well-behaved pet. Kasi siya talaga yung, ano, Senator Pia also brought her pets. I just wanted to mention that. And I was asking Senator Jinggoy to bring his pet. Anyway, Senator Jinggoy, paliguan mo na yung aso mo. Ayaw daw niya muna dali.
Mr. President, Senator Win Gatchalan would also like to insert into the records his manifestation with regard to this particular topic, Mr. President.
Yes, and personally, Madam Grace, I will support that measure wholeheartedly, and we'll make it a priority measure in this chamber so we can pass it.
Mr. President, just a short manifestation also again, Mr. President. May I move that we recognize our Deputy Minority Leader, Senator Risa Ontiveros.
Yes, Senator Risa Ontiveros, a distinguished Deputy Minority Floor Leader is recognized.
Salamat kaayo, Mr. President, and to the good gentle lady from Pangasinan, City of San Juan and Iloilo. My heartfelt congratulations from this two-legged animal, this representation. I had wanted to make a friendly interpellation, but I understand that we will schedule it for another time, Mr. President. So with the indulgence of the good gentlewoman, just like to make a brief manifestation that my questions at the proper time will involve education of adults on responsible pet ownership, then the effect of our proposed bills on existing legislation, including the existing amendments to RA number 8485 mentioned by the Her Honor, embodied in RA number 10631. The first RA passed in 1998 after lobbying by a woman of whom I am one of many nieces, Nita Ontiveros Lichauco, who was then president of the Philippine Animal Welfare Society. Later on also, Mr. President, questions about convincing DBM about the value of creating that new bureau proposed in the bill, as well ensuring that the provision is implemented of animal welfare enforcement officers or AWEOs from NGOs, that they be deputized by the DA. Also, if the standards in the bill will likewise apply to pounds and animal control facilities operated by our LGUs. And then since the good gentlewoman mentioned her pet tortoise, also how we can make sure that species like frogs, lizards, other reptiles, other species are also protected. We can't talk about animal cruelty without naming animal overpopulation as one of the root causes. And the majority leader already mentioned one of the important statistics from PAWS in 2019 of an estimated 12 million stray cats and dogs. And therefore, the question at the proper time, Mr. President, about humane animal control measures. For example, trap, neuter, vaccinate, return, or TNVR. I'm advised of this, Mr. President, by my child, my second daughter, Helena, who for several years now has been implementing such a TNVR program in our village. And lastly, Mr. President, Your Honor, the question in the future will be about how to provide better access to veterinary care and how to curb irresponsible importation and breeding. So very last, Your Honor and Mr. President, by way of support to NGOs such as we have in our presence today, who are also promoting adoption of animals, I just like to make of record a short list of some of them, some already mentioned by the good gentlewoman, a list given me by my eldest daughter, Isabella, who adopted two of her dogs, one from PAWS and one from Lara's Ark. And her short list, for those listening, also online, such animal adoption NGOs include Liwai's Furry Friends, PAWS Philippines, of course, Lara's Ark, Bark Mission, Potion Project, Cara Welfare, Hound Haven, Laguna Pitbulls Manila, and I'm sure there are many others. And God bless all of them, Mr. President. Salamat kaayo, mabuhay kayo, Senator Grace.
Thank you very much, Senator Rizon-Deveros. Majority Leader?
Yes, Mr. President, with that, I move that we refer the privileged speech of Senator Grace Poe and all the manifestations thereon to the Committee on Agriculture, Food, and Agrarian Reform. I so move, Mr. President.
There have been objections to the motion. The motion is approved. Maybe we ask for a minute suspension so that we can ask our furry friends to be guided to the pet park, the temporary pet park that we put outside. Session suspended for 1 minute.